Welcome back to my channel. In this video, we're going to go over the different kinds of relationships that occur on a phylogenetic tree. Phylogenetic trees are tools used to display classification and evolutionary relationships between taxa. You can look at different levels of relationships, such as species, family, class, or even higher on these trees. Monophyly, paraphyly, and polyphyly all refer to a type of relationship between taxa on a phylogenetic tree. Monophyly refers to a group of taxa that share a common ancestor. The monophyletic group is this ancestor and all of its descendants. If we look at our theoretical phylogenetic tree, there are many monophyletic groups within this tree. The first examples of monophyletic groups on this tree are the smallest groupings. A grouping of B and C with a common ancestor at this node form a monophyletic group, as does E and F and a common ancestor at this node. In addition, G and H form a small monophyletic group with a common ancestor at this node. Up from there, the taxa A, B, and C also form a monophyletic group with a common ancestor higher up the tree at this node. E, F, G, and H form a monophyletic group, as well as D, E, F, G, and H. All taxa A through H belong to a larger monophyletic group at this node. The second type of phylogenetic relationship we're going to go over is paraphyly. Paraphyly refers to a group of taxa that include a common ancestor but only some, not all of its descendants. If we look at our theoretical phylogenetic tree again, a paraphyletic group here could be taxa A and B. They share the common ancestor at this node, but this group does not include all of its descendants, as it does not include C. Another example could be a grouping of A, B, C, and D. They share the same common ancestor at this node here, but do not include all of the descendants of this common ancestor, E, F, G, and H. The third type of phylogenetic relationship we're going to go over is polyphyly. Polyphyly refers to a grouping of two or more unrelated species that do not have the same common ancestor. They are often grouped for other reasons than evolutionary origin, such as by having similar or shared physical features. If we look at our theoretical phylogenetic tree, an example of a polyphyletic group could be taxa C and F. And that concludes this video on monophyly, paraphyly, and polyphyly.
Thank you for watching. If you want to support this channel, please subscribe and check out more of my videos.